In this video, we will show you how to perform active low pass filter using op-amp. This is the circuit of active low pass filter. It consists of IC741 and at pin number 3 we can observe that a resistor R1 and C is connected and we are giving the AC input signal from function generator to pin number 3 through resistor R1. This both R and C forms the low pass filter and resistor R1 is connected to pin number 2 and that is grounded. And a feedback resistor that is RF is connected between 2 and 6. We give the input signal from function generator here and we also observe the AC waveform at pin number 6 using CRO. These are all the samples reading which I have already taken. In this tabular column, we can observe that we are applying the frequency in Hertz and we are measuring the output voltage at pin number 6 and we are calculating the gain, that is V0 divided by Vin. Here we apply the input voltage as 1 volt and we change the frequency. At same time we observe the output at pin number 6. Okay, by observing this reading we can observe that the output voltage goes on reducing. Once we reach cutoff frequency, the output voltage is near to zero voltage. This is because we have designed this low pass filter for 1.65 kilohertz. We can design the cutoff frequency by using this formula. The formula is given as f is equal to 2 pi RC. Once we substitute this value, the f is 1.59 kHz. It is not 1.65 kHz, it is 1.59 kHz. That means till 1.59 kHz we will get the output voltage. After 1.59 kHz, the output voltage goes on reducing. This can also be observed with the help of the graph. This is the graph or frequency response of low pass filter. Once we reach the cutoff frequency, the output voltage goes on reducing. Let's do this practically. Here we can observe that the active low pass filter is constructed on the breadboard. This is R and C. It is connected to input and this is a feedback resistor and this resistor is connected to pin number 3 and that is grounded. This is a low pass filter and this op-amp forms the non-inverting amplifier. We apply the input from function generator and we have to observe the output at pin number 6. Let's apply the input using function generator. I have connected the channel 1 to the input and channel 2 is connected to output of CRO. Now apply the signal with the help of function generator. Here we can see that initially we are applying 320 Hz and 1 volt. Let's observe that waveform in CRO. Here the channel 1 is connected to input, channel 2 is connected to output. Here we can observe that the input voltage is 1 volt peak to peak and output is almost, it is 2 volt at the output. As I increase the frequency, I will keep it to 1 kilohertz. Once I keep this frequency to 1 kHz, here we can observe that the input voltage remains same, but whereas the output voltage goes on reducing. Here we can see that the output voltage is almost 1.8 volt instead of 2 volt. Now again I will increase this frequency to 2.5 kHz. or 2.3 kHz. And now observe the output voltage. Here we can see that instead of 1.8 volt, here we are getting 1.6 volt. Again, now increase the frequency from 2.3 kilohertz to 5 kilohertz. I will change the range. I will make it to 5 kilohertz. Here we have given the 5 kilohertz and observe the output. This one is the output. Here instead of 1.8 volt we are getting 1 volt. Now give the 5 kilohertz from 5 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz and observe the output. Here we are getting almost 0.6 volt. In this way, we conduct the low pass filter. As we go near to the cutoff frequency, the output voltage goes on reducing. Once we note down this reading and draw the graph, we will get the exact cutoff frequency.